I am Dr. Ganesh Patil from KTHM College Nasik. Today we are going to learn chapter number 1, interest and annuity. In this lecture we will discuss on simple interest. Let us start. Interest and annuity. In this lecture we will learn interest, basic terms, simple interest, compound interest, nominal and effective rate of interest and relation between them. Number 6, annuity. In annuity, ordinary annuity, sinking fund, annuity due, present value and future value of annuity. 7, equated monthly installment, that is EMI, by interest of reducing balance and flat interest method. Interest. It is charge which is paid on borrowing money and is received on lending the money. It is based on the concept of time value of money, which state that rupees 100 of today is not equal to rupees 100 of tomorrow. For example, suppose we deposit rupees 100 in bank and after 1 year we will get more than rupees 100, that is depend on the rate of interest. So we say that rupees 100 of today is not equal to rupees 100 of tomorrow. Basic terms. Number 1, principal / present value. The present value or value in the beginning or the sum borrowed is called principal. For example, deposited amount is known as principal value. Loan amount is known as principal value and it is denoted by P. Term. The time or period for which principal value is borrowed is called term. It is denoted by N. Rate of interest. The rate at which principal value is borrowed is called rate of interest. It is denoted by R and generally it is percentage per annum. Number 4. Amount, also known as future value. The future value of principal at the nth period called an amount. That is sum returned by the borrower or principal together with interest is called amount. It is denoted by capital letter A. What is simple interest? We borrow some amount or money from a bank or a money lender. This borrowed amount is called as loan. However, at the time of returning the loan to the bank or money lender, we have to pay back an amount somewhat bigger than the loan. The additional amount is called as simple interest. Simple interest. It is the interest on principal amount for the entire period. It is denoted by I. Simple interest can be computed as below. Simple interest is equal to I is equal to PRN divided by 100. Simple interest is equal to I is equal to PRN divided by 100. Where P is equal to principal value. R is equal to rate of interest in percentage per annum. N is equal to term in the year. Terms in the year. N is equal to terms in the year. Not month, not day. It is a term in the year. Amount A is found by adding interest to the principal. Amount A is found by adding interest to the principal, that is A is equal to P plus I. Amount A is equal to principal plus interest. Amount A is equal to principal value plus interest. That is, amount A is equal to P as it is. We have to put the value of I in this formula, and the value of I is equal to PRN divided by 100. Therefore, we get A is equal to P plus PRN divided by 100. In this equation, P and this P are same. So, we take as a common. Therefore, we get A is equal to P in bracket 1 plus RN divided by 100. So, in this simple interest, we have get two formula, that is I is equal to PRN divided by 100, and another formula, amount of simple interest, A is equal to P in bracket 1 plus RN divided by 100. Let us see some example. Example number 1. What will be the simple interest on rupees 1200 at 10% per annum for 3 years? What will be the simple interest on rupees 1200 at 10% per annum for 3 years? Solution. In this example, the given information is P is equal to 1200, R is equal to 10% per annum, rate of interest, R is equal to rate of interest, 10% per annum, for 3 years, therefore N is equal to 3 years. In this example, these 3 things are given, P is equal to 1200, what will be the simple interest on rupees 1200, this is basic principal amount, 1200, so we get P is equal to 1200. R is equal to 10%. In the given example, the rate of interest is 10%, so we get R is equal to 10%, and N is equal to number of year, and number of year is equal to 3 years. We have a formula, I is equal to PRN divided by 100. In this formula, we put the values of PRN and we get I is equal to, put the value of P, 1200, value of R, 10%, value of N, 3%, and we get 1200 into 3 into 10 divided by 100. For simplifying this equation and divided 100, we get 12 into 3 into 10, we get rupees 360. Therefore, simple interest is rupees 360. Example number 2. Find the simple interest on rupees 1250 for 2.5 year at 12% per annum. In this example, the given information is P is equal to basic principal value 1250, R is equal to rate of interest 12%, R is equal to 12%, N is equal to number of year, and number of year is 2.5 year, so N is equal to 2.5. We have formula I is equal to PRN divided by 100. We put the value of P, R, N in this formula. Therefore, P is equal to 1250, R is equal to 12%, and N is equal to 2.5%. We get I is equal to 1250 into 12 into 2.5 divided by 100. After simplifying, we get 37,500 divided by 100. And after simplifying this, here 20 and 20 cancel, therefore I is equal to 375. The simple interest is rupees 375. In this lecture, we solved two examples on simple interest. In my next lecture, we will solve some more examples of this topic. Let us remember, simple interest is charge which is paid on borrowing money and is received on lending the money. Basic term. Also, we remember this basic term, principal value. The principal value or value in the beginning or sum borrowed is called as principal value and it is denoted by P. Term, the time or period for which principal is borrowed is called term. It is denoted by N. Rate of interest. The rate at which principal is borrowed is called rate of interest. It is denoted by R and generally it is percentage per annum. Formula. You have to remember these two formula. First is simple interest is equal to PRN divided by 100 and another amount of simple interest A is equal to P in bracket 1 plus RN divided by 100. These two formula are very important. If you have any difficulty related to this topic, you can send email on ganeshpatil@ktjmcollege.ac.in. Thank you very much.